All right, good morning, everybody. Welcome to Diamond Zone. Happy Friday. Hey, everyone. Hi. And before we get started, guys, I do want to say, please, prayers for everything that happened in Florida, that evil act, and with this just horrific. And I just want to make sure I said to make sure, you know, keep those kids in your prayers today. So what we're going to do today, guys, is like we do on every Friday. We have our motivational video. I do want to show everybody, because I really haven't seen the full video, the new company video that just came out. And then Lisa's going to come up and clarify some things from yesterday's training. Okay, so, and also have an open mic for you guys to ask questions today. So let's first talk about the motivational video. You know, one of the things I always talk about, and you guys know this because you're on with me every day, when you know that you know, you become more bold, right? You become somebody that cannot ever be moved by other people's opinion because you know that you know. It's called boldness. And I want to shout out to Roy for sending this out to me. And we're going to play this today as our motivational video.
Have you ever asked yourself the question, why is it that some people are more bold than others? Hi, John Maxwell here. Welcome to Minute with Maxwell. I've asked myself that question. Why is it that there are some people, they just step up and some people step back? Some people, they stand up. Some people sit down. Is it the fact that the people that stood up knew more than the people that sat down? Is it the people that, you know, walked forward knew more than the people that kind of retreated? I mean, is it the fact that people that are always bold are always better? I don't think so. I think they're just more passionate. And more passionate can make you better. Let me explain that. The moment that I back down, sit down, retreat, I lose the potential of that moment. Trust me. Nobody ever retreated. Nobody ever pulled back and got better. Now, there are times in life we need to pull back. There are times we need to retreat. There are times we need to give ourselves some time to think things through. I'm not saying that. But what I'm saying is, if I'm constantly pulling back from every adventure, every opportunity, every challenge before me, I'm never going to maximize myself nor maximize that opportunity. That's a fact. So what causes a person to go forward? What causes a person to go forward and be bold is the fact that they're passionate. They believe in what they're doing. In fact, they believe in what they're doing. They're willing to stand alone. They're willing to go alone. I've known many leaders who didn't lead anybody. Nobody was following them. But it didn't matter. They had to go out there themselves and make sure that they're what they thought was to be true. And so off they went. And in their boldness and in their behavior, they went out and found what they were looking for. So what happens is bold people, they don't know more than people that are more reticent. They're just more passionate about what they know. Did you catch that? They don't know more than people that retreat. They're just more passionate about what they know. I learned a long time ago, it's not knowledge that will make you successful. It's what you do with that knowledge. It's how you apply that knowledge. All transformation is a result of application, a result of action. So I encourage you, what are you passionate about? Whatever that is, step up, step out. What you'll discover is, it's on the journey that you make your greatest discoveries. Nobody ever makes great discoveries sitting and waiting. Walking and finding is where they find them. And that's what boldness does for you. Glad you're with me today on Minute with Maxwell.
How about that, guys? Does that not say it all? Does that not say it all? That's our business right there. Roy, thank you so much for that. And, you know, guys, I encourage you, if you have anything, I've been sending out and playing the ones that you guys send me because you guys are very aware of what it takes to make it in this business. But if I had to pick one thing, I really believe I always say, when you know that you know, and everybody else knows that you know, your journey is never ending. It's amazing what could happen when you could lead people based on your beliefs. And it does take some type of boldness, whether that's walking into a networking event, that could be boldness of making that first phone call, getting your first two. There's different levels of boldness. And that's what people follow. People are looking for a leader, and that's what Diamond Zone is. That's what we want to create here, is a group of people that believe and go out there. Because as I said, this nucleus of 100 to 120 people that support this, we could have millions of people just from 120 people with boldness. And there's no doubt about it. Okay. So with that, I do want to play our brand new company, 3.5 minute video and with our new logo. So I'm excited. I haven't yet to really watch the whole thing. So let's go full screen and let's all watch it together.
Welcome to Life Sensing Technology, where technology meets help. We are proud to introduce you to Hilo. With more than 800,000 pieces sold in its first year, Hilo has already captured the media's attention from around the world and has been successfully showcased at the 2018 CES convention in Las Vegas. Hilo is a wearable smart band device that performs measurements in real time while you are doing your daily activities, such as working, walking, running, and even sleeping. The continuous monitoring of your most important vital signs allows Hilo to alert you if your numbers are out of normal range. The latest version, Hilo LX Plus, with its clinical-grade sensors, offers you additional measurements with a high degree of precision. Hilo LX Plus can also measure ultraviolet rays and alert you if your exposure is too high to these harmful rays. Hilo learns about you day by day, constantly improving in accuracy and performance. All the data that Hilo registers, together with the reports that you can access because of the LifeLog platform, will become a real treasure for your self-care, will guide you to a better behavior, and will lead you to change any undesirable habits. Now that's what we call total peace of mind. What makes Hilo even more unique and fun is the Hilo App Store. Thanks to the powerful open API, any software developer can create and publish their own apps and plugins. Many apps are already available. Some of these include Hika, with all the common measurements, blood pressure measurements, EKG measurements, and even oxygenation exclusively for Hilo LX Plus, Lifestyle Index, and Hilo Fit and Hilo Fit Pro, and many more apps, like the just-announced breakthrough technology of the Sugar Trend software, are coming. Thanks to an additional device called Extense, apps can be developed to reach sugar trends. Wow, you heard right. The first ever worldwide non-invasive technology. It's absolutely amazing. But life sensing technology is not just about sensing your body's trends. It is also about helping to protect your life. Every day, a hidden enemy called electrosmog attacks our bodies, altering the water molecules of our body, which results in damage and negative effects to our DNA. World now has the solution, which offers the protection you have been missing. Introducing BioZen, a small chip with a big difference. BioZen has been scientifically proven to drastically reduce the harmful effects of electrosmog. All you have to do is stick BioZen on any electrically powered device. That's it. It is so crystal clear that life sensing technology is the next biggest thing. Now that you see the power of these products and this market, it will be easy to answer these three simple questions. First, do you see how life sensing technology can be potentially a lucrative business? Second, would you want to financially benefit from this emerging market without any high startup cost or any special requirements? And third, do you know of at least two people that would be interested in this product or in an opportunity with this market? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then you are the person we are looking for to join our movement. Please get back to the person that shared this video with you so you can find out the next steps on how to join our referral program in over 195 countries. Again, welcome to Life Sensing Technology. Become a world changer now.
All right. What do you guys think? Thumbs up? Okay. I love it. I love the message. And very, very simple. I love the questions. And it allows us to set up that video. You know how we talk about setting up that video before you send it to better your chances for the follow-up and everything that comes after. So I guess that is in your back office now. That's where I got it. So make sure you guys have it, and it'll be updated, I'm sure, on Hilo Life and everybody's websites. So please make sure that you have that video and start sending it out. All right. So I'm going to go to Lisa. Okay. Where is Miss Lisa? There she is. And I'm going to make her a co-host. Boom, boom. And then we will open it up also, guys. And one more thing. Tomorrow morning at 9, I am doing the company Get Started training. Okay, so I'd love Diamond Zoners to support that. Tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock, I'm doing the Get Started training for the company. So with that, Miss Lisa, are you there?
Let me unmute myself. I'm here.
Okay. You want to close your door?
Oh, yeah. I always forget to do that. Hi, everyone. 2 days in a row? Oh, my gosh. All right. I wanted to get back on today, really just to kind of clarify, to tighten up what I talked about yesterday. I did get some calls, and I realized I wanted to make sure my message was correct and just make some adjustments in what we talked about. Obviously, we all know, you know, team developer is the name of the game. We want to be team developer factories. Why do you think they have this new team developer bonus? It's because they want people to be incentivized to help their people get to team developer. If it wasn't important, they wouldn't have this bonus in place. And so I really want to kind of just talk about it again and just kind of clarify some of these points. Because again, like I think when I did the training yesterday, there was probably a little confusion, and I'll take responsibility for that. So to start with, you know, again, when you get someone started, you guys, it's really important. And we've been launching a lot of people and getting them, you know, started with World. And right now, you know, with the new video, you guys, it couldn't be a better time to circle back with every single person that you know and make sure that you kind of talk about what's happened over the last year and where we're going, and show them the new video and how the company has progressed. That's a huge, huge sell. And so I really believe this is the perfect time for everybody to be basically starting over and relaunching their business. But again, when you get somebody started and you're doing these, I think Zoom is a great way to do their launch calls, to do their launch strategy. I like to do it over Zoom because you could really talk to the person. Versus over the phone, you know, if you could be with them in person, even better. But you know, obviously, you know, you got to do what you got to do because we're all over the country. So first of all, I talked about this yesterday, just to kind of recap quickly. Getting into their why is really important. Asking lots of questions, finding out what their motivation is. I love the tape that the video Jeff played. John Maxwell talked about motivation and passion. Got to find out their passion. When people know you care and they know you're, you know, rooting for them, it makes a big difference. It really does. And so develop that relationship, really talk to them, get to know them, figure out what drives them, spend that time on the front end before you get into the strategy. Again, these bullet points I always like to go over. Listen, my job is to really motivate you. It's to steer you in the right direction. But if you succeed in this business, it's going to be you that creates that success, not me. And if you fail in this business, it's going to be you that creates that failure, not me, which is going to really lead into what I want to say next. And my job is to get you there as quickly as possible and get you independent from me. Is that okay? So that kind of sets up what we do when we start to talk about the launch. Okay. So having said that, You know, a lot of times if I'm on this call with somebody's new person, I'm just going to say, let's make sure you went through the welcome letter, and I'll pull up the welcome letter and I'll check, 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 check. Again, I'm just inspecting what I expect. And just, I love when the new person, if I'm helping somebody and they're pulling in the power, because that's what we're going to talk about too today, that all that's done. And it's really important that if you pull in your upline diamond, make sure, make them proud. Make sure that I'm not there to go over the welcome letter. I'm there to talk strategy, but I am going to say check, 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 check. And that new distributor is going to feel really excited that they got all those points covered and they got their person set up on the capture page, helo.life. I mean, that's important. Let's get professional, right? All right. Next, I'm going to always say, do you have your list of 100 names? Okay. Because if I'm, again, getting on the phone with somebody and launching them, I'm not going to get on the phone unless they did that. They took the time on a legal pad. There's something about writing down the names, 100 names. They went to their phone. They went to their Facebook. They dug deep. They might have even categorized them. That's a whole nother training. And then they highlighted their top 20. Okay. Because remember, as soon as someone signs up, that's when the 7 days starts. I talked about that yesterday. It's not when they place their order. It's as soon as they join, they get stamped in the system and their 7 days starts. And again, the company is paying us to get them to team developer in 7 days. And they're giving us shares and giving us a bonus because they want us to be responsible to help them. So again, that's why the emphasis is there. And I'm going to keep saying that. So first of all, when you're getting somebody launched, and going back to my little diagram that I had yesterday, okay, your job is to help that person get there too. So if I go back up, hold on, get my little pen, make sure this is black, make sure I've got a pen. Okay, so you got your 100 name list. And you highlighted their top 20 and you talked to them about their why. Okay. This is where you're focusing. You're focusing on helping them work through their list. And when they're working through their list, what are they doing with their list? You're coaching them on the invite. Because remember, we're the professionals, we're the experts. You're coaching them on sending the 3-minute video. You're coaching them on the follow-up. And remember, this person has already watched the Get Started training with Jeremy Roma, right? That's on the welcome letter. So this is recap. This is recap. But now I'm the coach. I'm coaching them on the calendar and the 30-minute live or recorded Zoom meetings. And I'm coaching them on getting me on 3-way calls, right? So here you are, the person buys their, and again, I'm not going to get into details on packs today. I want to talk strategy. They're buying their professional pack, hopefully. Our job is to help them get there too, right? Because we're working with their list. We're sitting there going, okay, and this is where the intensity level happens, because you know you have 3 shares on the table, because if I sponsored this person right here, and this is me, I've got 3 shares on the line, and this person has 3 shares on the line. We both know what we want to do in this 7-day period. Yes? Correct. So you're working intensely with them. Now, when they get their first person, they're going to go here, okay? By the way, we talked about this. They're always going to go to the outside. If this is the outside, if I'm here, it's always going to go to the outside left, outside the bigger leg first. That's the leg that, if this is me, that I'm going to spill over into. Then I'm working, we're working. They get their second person. It goes here. Now, let me tell you, this is beautiful, perfect scenario. This is where the breakdown is. I really believe everybody, for the most part, is doing this with this person. This is where the breakdown is. When you get your first two people, are you doing it with them? Are we creating that intensity level, the same intensity you did with your first person, with the two people that they brought in? And are you, right here, this is you, still involved in that coaching process? So in other words, remember those three shares? Our job is just not to stop here, helping that person get there too. Those three shares are not going to manifest themselves until this person gets their two and this person gets their two. So I'm going to tell you right now, this is the breakdown. It really is. I see strings of people getting their people because you're working with your guy and he's getting one and two and three and four and five. He's bringing people in. He's bringing people in and he's hoping that somebody's going to get their two. The breakdown is moving up the chain and working with the same intensity level with these two people, helping them to get their two. Now, if done correctly, okay, and if done with speed, because you're following the system that's taught, this is done in 24 hours, and we want to get this done in 48 hours, it's a beautiful thing. And people have experienced that, okay? Because everybody is doing what they're supposed to do. And then this person has learned how to do it. So when he gets these two people in, see, now there's the duplication that starts to happen. This person right here tends to pull away because they've got new people they're launching. Am I not right? But this person here is now pulling up the ranks to help these two people with this person get their two. See, it's teach and release. Teach and release. So in other words, I taught this guy how to complete the structure. So now these two people, okay, person A and person B, they experienced it working, right? They saw what was happening. This person right here got to team developer. Now, what is he going to be paid to do? He's going to be paid to help person A and person B get in the trenches with them to help these two people duplicate down, getting in their list, getting their top 20, and sponsoring their two people. See how this all starts to duplicate, because he's getting paid three shares and this person's getting paid three shares. See what the company is paying us for? To create this structure. And then it continues to duplicate. See, if multi-level marketing, you don't release until the structure's done. Then the people know how to do it and they teach it and release the new structure, and it starts to duplicate down, and it's a beautiful thing. Okay. But I'm going to get into second scenario and third scenario now. This is how it's supposed to be done. Okay. You're working with people and you're getting paid the three shares to get this done. You're working with them bell to bell every single day. You guys, those first seven days, you are in bed with them. I'm just saying, man, you say you set up those working rules and you say, I remember doing a call with somebody. I go, when you call me, this phone is going to start beeping like the bat line. It's going to go off and it's red because we have a 7-day window to get you to team developer. You are high priority to me. I'm going to talk to you every day. You're going to talk to me every day. We're going to be doing three-way calls. In the morning, you're going to be lining them up with me. That's the kind of intensity I'm talking about. So
can I make a point here?
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Okay. I want to make sure you guys understand something.
And I'm going to, okay, go ahead.
Okay. So you want me to go or not?
Go.
Okay. So here's what I want to make sure you guys understand. When you sit down with somebody, at least the size, when you sit down with somebody, okay, this is where you find out if you're going to have a bat line. You're not going to beat up somebody that isn't moving within 48 hours. You got to move past them.
Yeah, and that was my next point.
Okay, well, why don't you go ahead?
That's love us. Oh my gosh. Okay, don't you love him? Oh my God. Okay, so we got this intensity. Now, I'm gonna talk about bringing in the troops. If this is the new person and they get there too, and this is you, let's say it's Fran, and this person gets there too, that's when Fran, and this is a good thing to do, you guys, that's when Fran is going to call in her upline, which happens to be Jeff and Lisa, Lisa or Jeff, to help with the structure. It's just another level of intensity. Now, this has been happening, and I'm really pushing this down. I am not going to get on a call with a structure until this person has their two, and it's within 7 days. Now, Fran and Lisa are setting up a call with person A, person B, person C, and now we're having another Zoom meeting because now we're having another intensive team call with this little structure to get person B and C moving to get their two. You're pulling in your upline for that intensity within the 7 days. Now, of course, remember, this person has their list of 100 people in their top 20. This person has their list of 100 with their top 20. And that's when it's going to spawn off the other two, because now it's kind of like you're bringing in reinforcements. And again, my motivation is for Fran and for person A to get their three shares. That's all we want to do is continue to duplicate. And you know what's going to happen to you guys? Person B and person C and person A, you know what they're going to see? They're going to see their upline diamond support. That makes people excited. It gets people's confidence up. It motivates them. It puts pressure on them. Okay, now we're pulling in Gus and Jan. Now we're pulling in Shaylisa. Now we're pulling in Sheila. We're pulling in, you know, all the diamonds, Dan Mays. We're pulling in somebody because we're now increasing the intensity level. We didn't stop at two. We're going to complete the process. Okay? Now, speaking to Jeff's point, this is where I want to clarify. I bring in person A, and we go to work with him. He's got his list of 100 people. He's got his top 20. And let's say this is Fran. Fran, you're working with him. You're going through the welcome letter. You're being intense with this guy. You're saying, okay, let's go. You're doing your three-way calls. He's doing his 3, 7, 30. And there's an intensity level to get the two. He gets his first one, Bob. And Bob is a guy he works with, okay? And then he gets the second one, Bill. And Bill happens to be a neighbor. Now, Fran is doing what she's supposed to do with person A. They immediately drill up, okay, to Bob and Bill, just like they were taught to do. And they get the list going, and they go through the welcome letter, and they say, you come back to me, and you give me your list of 100 people, and we're going to work with your top 20, because our goal in the first 24 hours is to get your two. And person A says, you know what? When your phone rings, it's going to blow up like the bat line. And then all of a sudden, They call Bob the next day and there's crickets. He's busy. He's at the soccer game. He's at, he's bowling. He's busy. He decided to go on vacation. He's not calling back. Are you going to sit there and worry about Bob? No, you move, to Jeff's point. Bob may come back around in a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks. If you don't have people doing this and you don't have people responsive to wanting to get in the trenches with you to get there too, you have to move. And that does not mean, okay, this is where I want to make the correction, and my bad, okay? I think what we're doing is that we're trying to focus on structure, but we're not going to go ahead and say, okay, the next two people I bring in, I'm just going to go ahead and give them to Bob. No, that's not the message. What I'm saying is, if you work with somebody and they're not responsive, and you work with this guy and the same thing happens, he's basically, you know, he's not calling his list, or he's calling his list and the list isn't responding, and he's trying to set up three-way calls and no one wants to get on the call, and you're coaching him, and it's just, you're doing everything you should do. You're bringing in Betty, this is you, and now you're going to work with Betty, and you're lighting a fire with Betty, and you're lighting a fire with Ted. And now you're doing the same thing here. So now we're with the next two. And here you are. You're going to be doing the same thing with these two. You're going to get in the list of 100. You're going to, you know, start calling the top 20, because it's within the 7 days. Okay? And you want to get those. You don't just stop and go, oh, my God, my first two were duds. I didn't get my team developer done. You're working with a fury to get somebody to, it's kind of like you're lighting a fire. Okay, now let me explain to you what can happen. All of a sudden you light a fire. Bob doesn't light, right? This guy, you know, he doesn't light. But now all of a sudden you're up here and Betty, she's on fire. She lights a fire. She gets her first one because you're working with her, right? Here you are working, and this person up here, Ted, he starts to light a fire. Now you got two people that are starting to go, and Ted gets his first one. This is where, once again, if this is Fran, now what she's doing is you want to counsel up. Here I am, okay? Shaylisa, Anne Marie, Dan Mays. If I'm leaving anybody out, Gus, you're grabbing your upline, because now you have somebody, you have a person and a person who got in, two people that are now going. They start, they're moving, they're responsive, they're doing what they're supposed to do, they're on the calls, you're working with them. Now they got their first person and they got their second person. This is where the intensity level should go high, so that this Betty right here is working to get her second person. Now all of a sudden, I'm going to give you scenarios now. If you're working with your upline and it's the last day, 7 days in, and you guys, there's so many different scenarios that could happen. And you got Betty who got her two, and you got Ted who's got one. And you're working with Ted, and you're working with Ted, and Ted's like, he's trying, but he doesn't have a second person. You know, now you're going back to Ted, and you're going, Ted, okay, let's go through it. Did we get your, think about your kids? You think about your mom, your dad, your brother. You're getting in the weeds, because remember, our job is to get paid to shake the tree. Ted doesn't know how to shake the tree. Your job is to help Ted shake the tree. And Ted goes, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and get my mom in here. I'm going to have my mom grab that spot. I didn't know that we could do that and have her just get a spot, because she wants to get a helo. and I'm going to go ahead and pay for it for her because I'm going to make that her birthday present. See, there's so many different scenarios, you guys. What if Ted goes, you know, I don't have the money to put my mom in. My mom, you know, doesn't want to do it. Da, 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 da. It goes on and on and on. Now you're drilling down here. Let's say this person's name is Bill. Okay, I won't go Rain Man. Bill, you're one person away. This is what I was talking about yesterday. And I just want to clarify, just to tighten this thing up. You're one person away from getting Team Developer Bill within 7 days. Bill's working. He's got more people coming down the pike. He knows his mom wants a Hilo. She's not going to be a builder. She's just a customer. And he wants to get her a Hilo for a, you know, birthday present. He says, you know what? I'm going to put my mom here to get Team Developer done. And I'm going to pay for it and have the order forwarded back to me so that I can get TD done in 7 days. And my mom is just going to be a customer. And guess what, Ted? When you get the commission on that, I'd appreciate it if you threw it back. Okay? It's just called getting creative. And that's why it's so important with this new cluster for who got paid on that. 3 shares went here. Bill got 3 shares. But you have the upline diamond or upline president really looking at that cluster and helping you kind of sort through what the different potential possibilities could be. All right? What was that, Jeff? Okay, so that's it, guys. I wanted to clarify that. I want to open it up for questions, but I want to show one more thing. I also showed the family scenario, okay? So I hope that made sense. The family scenario, this is the other thing, and it's happening a lot. It happened, you know, we did it. You put a daughter here, and you put your son here. You got to remember, these entities belong to you. You probably purchased them, and you did it just to get, we always say, get your family sitting on top of what you're going to build. And then you're working, and let's say the son brings in his girlfriend, and let's say you bring in your boyfriend. And I talked about this yesterday. There's nothing wrong with putting the boyfriend here, because this is where, in a family dynamic type situation, you own these spots anyway. You see what I'm saying? And if I were going to fill these two spots just to get Team Developer done, it would be with people that are not going to build the business. There are scenarios where I'm putting my 80-year-old mother here and my stepdad here, and they both want to get a Hilo. You see what I'm saying? Because I want to get Team Developer done in a 7-day period. And I'm just structuring it. But again, remember, in the beginning, if this is you and you're working with your upline and you're each going to get 3 shares, this is where it's good to pull in somebody that could help with that strategy. Now, notice I wanted the boyfriend on the outside and I wanted the other girlfriend on the outside. If these two people have the ability and want to build it, you want to make sure that they're going outside, because that's where the spillover is going to occur. I'm not going to go ahead and put the boyfriend and the girlfriend on the inside, because my daughters are not building 2 legs. Okay? So I just wanted to clarify structure and make sure you guys know that this is really an art. It's simple, but sometimes it could be confusing. And what we want to do right now for the last 20 minutes, because I know there's some people that had questions yesterday, is just really open it up and let people ask questions.
Okay. All right. Shh. All right. Listen. Oh, my God. All right. So one thing I want to clarify, guys, and Lisa made this point. here's where I think the breakdown is. The breakdown is the person who's sponsoring the first two. And I'm telling you, that is where you find out very quickly if someone's going to run. I've always said it. The right people just do. And when you find that person, now all these scenarios, I think they're great, and I want you to know them. But when you pull in the Calvary, you don't have to worry about it. When you pull in the upline, we're going to be there, and this is how you learn. You don't learn it right here in 20 minutes. All you have to know is this: I got somebody good. And that's what Fran did so perfectly. Fran got with that person. We didn't have to worry about welcome letters. We didn't have to worry about if they're in their back office. Fran took care of all that. But then she said, Jeff and Lisa, or mainly Lisa, I got somebody good. And then she then was part of everything Lisa did. And that's how she now learns. It's not trying to figure out this and listen to this 55,000 times. Your job is to bring in the damn person. That's our job. Let's get the people. The structure will be there. Believe me, the support will be there when someone surfaces a new person. We get into the weeds sometimes, wondering about all these different scenarios, but yet we haven't sponsored anybody in 90 days. And I'm just being straightforward. Okay, what about this? What about that? Did you want to
do that?
Huh? What'd you say?
I agree. Some of the people calling me back about all these different scenarios haven't sponsored anybody in 90 days sometimes.
90 days? I mean, we're being generous. But my point is, guys, obviously when you have somebody, there will be the support because we're watching everything.
We are.
Everything that comes in on a daily basis. What's that? What's this? What's that? Does this person want to go? Because you know, you see the scenario Lisa has here? Okay, Juno, okay, and you gotta be smart. If I brought my two daughters here, I know without a doubt, I'm not under this ether that my daughters are gonna build it. I gotta bring in this person over here. You know, some people, because they have the financial wherewithal, let's just be honest, they buy all six spots. Ooh. Does that person have a structure? No, they don't have anything. It's a house of cards.
Well, they just got team developer done.
They got team developer done. That's all they did. Now they still got to keep sponsoring because the first six people probably are going to do nothing.
Yeah.
So it's being smart. That's all. I'm not saying not to. Go ahead.
And you know, to that point, that's why it's sometimes it's like, okay, let me get that team structure done. And with BioZen, knowing that BioZen is your cash flow card. BioZen is our ace in the hole, because anything that's purchased, if that were the case, you know, Jess, Jen, mom, dad, my stepdad, my stepmom, all that product is cash flow back.
See, some people
build your business.
Just remember, guys, some people have that financial wherewithal, because if you think about it, what did that cost? I'm not suggesting people do it, but people do. There's 7,000, 14, 21. Wait, it's 3,500, right? So 7, 14, 21, 25. So you're talking to a business person. They go, structure yourself with 25,000. And if it takes you 2 years to move the product, you're going to net 25% on your money. Well, a business person goes, got it. No big deal. I'm not worried about the 25,000.
They have a vehicle. Back up. They have a vehicle to move it.
They have a vehicle to move it. And guys, understand, you don't build your business and think about that. You don't do that. This is the point I want to make. Your job is to get them the welcome letter. Your job is to bring in the new person. And if you're raw, bring in your upline quickly so we could help you with this new person. That's the message. All right. So I'm going to unmute. All right. Let me unmute. I'm sure some of you have.
Okay.
Go ahead. Wait, Lisa.
One, do you keep your, did you unmute me, baby?
Yes.
You are unmuted. Do you keep your daughters active in the loyalty? Okay, if this is daughter one and this is daughter two, no, not, I didn't. That's a personal choice. I'm not paying $59 a month for each daughter I just choose not to. If each daughter wants to pay their loyalty because they want the points, they can do it. That's just something you got to discuss with, you know, or you want the extra points, 70, you know, you want the extra $75 points per person. That's an option.
Okay. Go ahead, Jenny.
They don't lose their spot without a loyalty.
Hi, Jenny. This is Jenny. Hi. Lisa, a couple of things. One is when you're starting to put family members in and stuff and you're just going to buy them a Hilo, isn't there a minimum of 450 points that of sales volume that you have to have in those spots
No.
in order to qualify for TV?
No. I talked about that yesterday, Jenny. Structure has nothing to do with points. These could all be single helos. And what is the, I always got to look, what is it, 120 on a single helo?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm confused because I did ask that of customer service one time, and that's what they told me because somebody did want to come in at just a single helo.
They have to have at least 100 SV.
100 SV.
Wonderful. Okay, that's good news. And Jeff, to you, thank you for addressing my suggestion about follow-up. The question that I didn't hear you answer, and I'm sorry if I missed it, is if I've used the Hilo.life app and people did not click through, now you're saying circle back with this new video, and will that be trackable in the Hilo.life app?
Sure.
At some point? Okay, it's not there yet. I just checked.
I will find out today. I saw what you
okay.
wrote.
Yes. Yeah, and then the other question is, I've had, it was actually an Uber driver when we were in LA who was a young girl, and she's clicked through like 10 times on that one BioZen video because I told her about it, and she won't, and then I follow up saying, hey, got any questions? Can we talk? Whatever, she goes in the witness protection program. How do you pursue those people when you see them click through and they don't get back to you?
You don't.
Okay, you just let them go.
You don't.
Okay.
Here's a good question, Teresa. She said, when does your 7 days start? My understanding is if somebody gets started on Saturday, anytime on Saturday, Friday night at midnight. Okay, Friday night at midnight would be their 7 days. But if you go to this person's back office, what I thought was super cool is if you go to this person's back office and you click on TD, Team Developer tab, it's going to show when they started it with the time date and how much time they have left. So this way you can see, she's got 24 hours left. She's a pumpkin at, you know, midnight. So that's where you could really look to make sure.
Okay, good. All right, you guys are unmuted. You got questions, comments? You guys are free.
Yeah. Any questions about anything else too? That
Lisa.
Go ahead, Gus.
Okay, thank you. Can you just reinforce? And I know you'll know which one this is with. I don't want to mention the name, but when we came on, we talked about spillover in terms of what I've put in on that right leg, and we went into the back office and said, oh, well, you're not on loyalty. So that would just flush. That probably did more as an incentive for him than anything at this point. But in other words, if you're not on loyalty, how that volume flushes.
Well, actually, because that's a good point, Gus. Okay, here's the guy you're talking about. It's not that he needs to be on loyalty.
Right.
It's he needs to have... So that's not the case. He's right here. He got in a couple months ago under Gus. And since then, Gus continues to build. He's got a bunch of people down his right leg. But there's zero volume on his right and zero volume on his left because there's no accumulation of the spillover on the right leg. And the reason why is because anything that happens will not accumulate unless person A does at least 30 SV a month. So how does he get 30 SV a month? He's got to sponsor somebody who gets on loyalty, or he has to do the volume, like he's selling a watch every month. Easiest way to do it is you get one person on loyalty. That just took care of you being active. And when that happens, the spillover will start accumulating.
Right.
And this is the other thing we talked about with that person.
Thank you.
This is another good point, Gus. And this is for some of you that have these situations. There's a lot of people that are coming up from, you know, the grave. Maybe they got frozen and they might have that situation where they have some spillover and they might even have some accumulation of points. I always tell people, I don't care what you have down this right leg. Remember, Gus, I told him that? I said, you still want to put five yes. people right,
five
people left.
Right.
Because it's all about you building your structure.
Right.
And again, we talked about team developer. And then once you get team developer done, you're going to keep putting four more on your right, four right. more on your left, because you're building your foundation. Mm-hmm. And then once that's done, if this is the leg that gets bigger, then you can switch your strategy to the right leg.
Yep.
Exactly. And he loved that because, you know, if you're building it for the long term, you're going to flip your sides.
Exactly.
You don't want to just build one leg and say, oh, I never have to look at that other leg again. You should think that way.
Yep. Perfect. Thank you.
Perfect. Good question. Anybody else out there, guys, as we close out Friday? No questions, huh?
Thanks for the clarification.
Who's that?
Yeah, I did want to clarify on that, you guys, because you never, ever put two people in and just, okay, I'm going to put my next two people here, my next two people here. If I did that, I went Rain Man, my apologies. You don't do that. So your job is to drive the volume.
Well, I didn't take your training as you weren't teaching that. It was your training was figure it out. But my only problem was the person's not figuring it out by yourself. You have your upline that's there to support you, to help you figure it out. Okay, so that's so, I mean, come on.
Anne-Marie, yeah, at the end of the day, and I was talking to Anne-Marie Stroh. I mean, we know how to figure it out. The people that have been in the business, we're going to be like, I remember when we were going president, we brought in, what was our number, Jeff? 2020, something crazy like that.
40.
And we had on our left side, one of our people had this, and then we didn't have this done. Okay, this right here. And we had all this points accumulated on this side. We had over 50,000 points on this side and over 50,000 points on this side. This happened to be our power leg. So we were getting all of our spillover over here. We placed people on the left leg. I think we threw like 10 people over on the bigger leg and they weren't catching fire. They got one, maybe got one, got one. We're working with them. One got one. And it was the ninth hour. The volume's about to close out. If I didn't get a person over here, you listening to me, you guys, we wouldn't have got to president because you can't get to president without being a team developer. And I remember Jeff's like, he just knows, you know, that this is my department. Well, what I do, I put somebody here. Now it was a customer, but if I didn't do that and I was going to leave it up to Joe Blow to put somebody there, that would have cost us our rank of president. So it's just, you guys, you got to be smart. You think I would have let that happen?
They don't have to be smart. At least stop saying that. They don't have to be smart. Yes. They got a council.
Council.
I know you keep talking. I got it. Okay. How do you sponsor someone under the age of 18? Listen, I'm reading my lines. The contract says 18, but you're putting the date of birth in. So I'll just leave it there. Okay. Okay. That's all I'll say. But you have to be 18. You hear what I'm saying? Okay. To be in the structure. There's my answer. You have to be 18. I'm going to say it again. All right. Anybody else? Wait. Who else out there? I guess that's yeah. Who's that?
Brian.
Hey, Brian.
Hi. When you look at the structure on your in your back office, is it the left side on the left as you look at it, or okay? Because I have my structure all messed up, so I'm messing with it. But okay, well, it's this left and rest to right as you look at it.
If you go to your back office and you click on dual team, you're going to see the volume always in real time on your left side and your right side, and you're going to see what spilled over. It's called carry forward from the previous week.
Right.
You can also click on browse that up at the top of dual team, and it will show you the people, the little people.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Everybody needs more little people. We all need more little people. All right. Anybody else? Stro, do you want to say anything?
Yeah. Any last comments?
No, I was one of the ones that called Lisa last night, and we had a really good brief conversation. You hit it. And you're right. It's just people have to really lean on their upline. As soon as you get two, the first thing is get your two. I mean, we just need to really simplify this, get TD done, get it out of the way, strategize, and it can get moving. But again, I say this out of love and respect, get your two first and then let's giddy up, right? People are so worried about strategy when they don't even have their first yet. So go team builder first. And then let's get to work.
That's right there. That's it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and kind of piggybacking off that, if people want to do calls with one person pulling in their upline and that person hasn't gotten their two, that doesn't need to happen. You need to work with your people, helping them get their two, and then that's when you pull in the ranks.
Right.
Hey, Lisa, this is Teresa. This is fantastic. Thank you. I have one quick question. Maybe it's a request for next time because we're out of time. Anna Marie is wonderful. Thank you. So if we can do this type of strategy on the actual packages again, I know we touched on that yesterday, but not only structure, but the different packages now and how the points come into play. Because we're coming into, you know, building up those next levels, you know, some of those that are limited on the income, trying to come up with the best way, not only with BioZen as your application, but being able to turn around within, you know, the next 30 days of being able to make your money back. Just a little bit more strategy.
You talking about wholesaling, Teresa? You're talking about how to take that product and wholesale it in a scenario of 30, 60 days?
Well, yeah, that, and just because we have so many different packages now with the plus.
Got it.
If the BioZen wholesale is not real, where they really see making back their money, maybe it's just more of the team building. The best possible strategies for different packages to present based on different scenarios.
Got it. Okay, I got it. I'll streamline that, and we could do that with Lisa next week. That's a good. That could be a good training.
Perfect.
I did a little bit of that yesterday, and yeah. I think just spending more time on that is a good idea, because it is a little confusing. We get confused.
yeah, that's another conversation we're trying to have. I mean, but anyway, we'll streamline it. Yes. All right, guys, who wants to close this out today?
I want to close it out with something else rather than a question. I'm celebrating our 54th year of marriage today.
Oh.
Just 1.5 hours ago, we were. And in the process.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Lisa, press stop share so everybody could see.
Okay.
Congratulations, aww. Guys. Yay. 54. You got us by almost double.
You have to push stop share too, Jeff.
Now you will teach me to become as good as you are.
Hey, Gus, you had Gus and Fran, you guys had a great week last week. Why don't you, words of wisdom, Gus, to close out the call, and then Fran.
Sure. It's just a matter of continuing to continue. I mean, the time that we spent, and you mentioned it earlier, just talking with the active upline, once you have something going, just the ability to have it structured to be able to move up, because so often, even though we've built in the past, having the other head into the equation and structuring it. And then the other thing that was interesting to me, the byproduct of that, was with each person that I ran through with Lisa, and we got more this weekend, it became very apparent for them that the support is there. And the question that I got multiple times from different people was, so is this the type of support that I can continue to expect? And my answer was, as long as you're putting the people in, yes, we're here for you. But you're going to have to really put that work in. Once that's done, then we're going to continue with that structure. And I think just that, it's not a marathon. This is not a marathon. It's a relay race. It's a matter of putting that baton in that next person's hand. So I appreciate you both for that. And it raises everybody's belief around, including ours. So thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Gus. Go ahead, Fran.
Hi, everyone. Well, what I would say is, for me, and what happened this week, it's results equals belief. And the more that you do, and the more that you are focused and consistent, and you're getting the results, the higher the belief. And, you know, everybody's got challenges every single day, and you just have to be able to put those glasses on and just look forward and not listen to all the noise. And if you can do that and just stay focused, you'll do it.
And you know, one thing I'll say about Fran, you know, we've had many conversations, and she, you know, she does a lot of LinkedIn. She goes, Jeff, I keep sponsoring these duds. I keep sponsoring these duds. I goes, Fran, when you find the right ones, they just do. And now she just found one. And she's understanding. You're right. You can't make people do it. You could just be there to support them, okay, every step of the way. And like Gus says, that builds their belief and that gives them confidence. But you can't have a magic wand and make people do it. That's why you want to make sure when you bring a new person in, quickly find out what you got. You might throw them back, okay? Not that you do that, okay? You keep them in, of course, but you're not going to spend your time with somebody you're trying just to beat up to do it. That's all. That's all. Now your journey is so easy. It's less stressful because you go, okay, got to get another one. And that's what people leave out. They stop getting new ones. Okay. And we're all guilty of that. And that's what we all need to do. And I say it again, if everybody on Diamond Zone just brought in one person a week, do you understand? We Diamond Zone takes over this company. Diamond Zone takes over this company if everybody here got one person a week. That's it. So you got to think about it. Okay, so let's go to work. Let's get some people this weekend, guys. Support tomorrow, and love you guys. And Aman, happy anniversary, sir. Woo! All right, guys, talk to you soon. This has been recorded. Rain Man's been recorded.